Hello students, so today we are going to start discussing about our algebra model answer. Let's see how many of you have got full 20 on 20. So the test was for the chapter sets and real numbers. So let's start with our first question, that is, attempt any four of the following. It was a 4 marks. When I say 4 marks and you have 4 questions to be attempted, that is 1 mark each for 1 question. The first question is, write the following set in listing method. Set of prime numbers from 1 to 20. When I say listing method, you have to list down the elements. Listing method is also called as roster form. Set of prime numbers from 1 to 20. First of all, you have to think of the element. Prime numbers. What are prime numbers? Prime numbers are those numbers which are divisible by 1 in itself, but 1 is an exception. So the numbers, the prime numbers between 1 to 20 are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19. Now how to represent it? You will represent the set with a capital letter A. You can use any capital letter. You will put an is equal to sign. You will start the set with a curly bracket and you will write the elements separated by commas. And we all know the elements. It is 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19. And you will close the set with a curly bracket. If you have got this question right, give yourself 1 mark. And if you have got something wrong in this, you have to put yourself 0 mark. Since it is of 1 mark, it will be 1 or 0. Second question is, write the following set using rule method. And the set is X is equal to AET. AET are the elements. Rule method is nothing but set builder form. Now in rule method, how are you going to represent the set? Again, the set will be represented by the capital letter, and here the capital letter is mentioned in the question X. So you will consider the same one. AET are nothing but the elements in the word 8, eat, T. You can use any one. So we will write it as X is equal to a curly bracket. Then you will put the X as a representation and then you will put a straight line. Here it is slant, but you will put a straight line. X is a letter in the word 8. How you will read it? X is a set of all X such that X is a letter in the word 8. I repeat, here it will be a straight line. So if you have got it entirely correct, give yourself 1 mark. The third one is, state which of the following assert justify cube root of 51. You are supposed to tell whether it is assert or not. And the question is cube root of 51. Now we know there are 3 pointers to be checked if you want to prove whether it is assert or not. It is given over here that you have to justify it. So you have to write all the 3 points. The first point is related to order. If you observe over here, the order is 3. And our first pointer says the order needs to be a natural number greater than 1. And obviously 3 is a natural number greater than 1. So we are ready with the first point. 51 is the radicand. And the pointer says the radicand needs to be a positive rational number. And yes, 51 is a positive rational number. Pointer 3 says the entire term needs to be an irrational number. So cube root of 51 is an irrational number. We know it. All the 3 pointers are there. Therefore, it is proved that cube root of 51 is the assert. If you have written the justification, then give yourself 1 mark. If you have only written whether it is assert or not, then give yourself 0.5 mark. With justification, you will get full 1 mark. Without justification, you will get only 0.5 mark. Moving towards the fourth one, simplify 5 root 3 plus 8 root 3. That means you have to add it. We have studied it is nothing but like search. Root 3 are same. That means you can directly add it. So you are going to add the rational factors. And the rational factors are 8 and 5. 8 plus 5 gives you 13. And root 3 will come as it is. So the answer is 13 root 3. It was a very easy one. If you have got it correct, give yourself 1 mark. The fifth one is, compare the following pair of certs. root of 247, root of 274. When you are comparing, you have to check which one is greater, which one is smaller. So let's check the radicands first. 247, 274. We all know 247 is smaller than 274. Therefore, root of 247 is smaller than root of 274. If you've got it correct, give yourself 1 mark. There were 5 questions. You were supposed to attempt 4. So the marks for this question number 1 is 4. If you have written all the 5, put 1 mark as extra, because for question number 1, it is 4 marks. So you need, if you have got all 4 correct, that means you are getting 4 marks for question number 1. So we are done with question 1, moving towards question 2. Attempt any 3 of the following, 6 marks. There are 3 questions to be attempted, total 6 marks, that means 2 marks each for each question. Simplify 9 root 5 minus 4 root 5 plus root of 125. Guys, whenever you are simplifying, whatever third is provided in the question, you will write it in the simplest form. So first of all, I'll write the question as it is. 9 root 5 minus 4 root 5 plus root of 125. Now let's check whether the irrational factor is in the simplest form or not. 9 root 5. Root 5 is in the simplest form. It cannot be factorized further. Minus 4 root 5. Again, root 5 is in the simplest form. It cannot be factorized further. Root 125 can be factorized. If you factorized it, you will get it as 5 root 5. So in the place of root 125, you will write 5 root 5. So if you check the next step, you've got 9 root 5 minus 4 root 5 plus 5 root 5. That means all the three are like thirds, because you are having the irrational factors same. So you can add or subtract. So let's add, subtract the rational factors. That is 9 minus 4 gives you 5. 5 plus 5 gives you 10. So the answer is 10 root 5. If you have got it properly right, then give yourself 2 marks. If you have not got the final answer correct, then give yourself 1 mark if the step is correct of factorization. If the final answer is wrong, give yourself 1 mark. If you have got the entire sum correct, then give yourself 2 marks. Moving towards the next one. Observe the Venn diagram and write the following set. With the help of Venn diagram, you have to write the following set. The first one is A union B. A union B means you have to write all the elements of A and B together without repetition. A union B means you have to write all the elements of A and B together without repetition. So let's check the elements of A. It is X, Y, Z. The element of B is P, Q, R. And M and N is included in both. So we will consider both the circles, because both the circle includes all the elements of set A and B. And the elements of set A and B are X, Y, Z, M, N, P, Q, R. The next one is U, that is a universal set. Universal set includes all the elements which are there in the Venn diagram. It includes everything which is present in the geometrical figure. So you can see X, Y, Z, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T. So it is of 2 marks. You have 2 questions. One is A union B. The another one is universal set. So guys, if you have got both the answers correct, then it will be 2 marks. If you have got any one correct, then it will be 1 mark. 1 mark each for 1 question. So let's move towards the next one. Write the following numbers in decimal form. 121 upon 13. Write the following number in the decimal form. If you have to write it in the decimal form, simply you have to divide it. You have to do your basic traditional division and get the answer. The answer is 40.3333 will be recurring. You have to solve it by division method. So if you have got the proper, you have to show the division method also. If you have shown the division method and if you have write the final, if you have wrote the final answer properly, you will get 2 marks with this proper dots or else a recurring bar. So you will get 2 marks. If you have not shown the division step, then you will get only 1 mark. So steps are very important. The fourth one is, if n of a is equal to 15, n of a union b is equal to 29, if n of a intersection b is equal to 7, then n of b is what? Now we have got the values of n of a union b, n of a intersection b, and n of b. Now guys, whenever you have this kind of sum, we all know there is an identity which says n of a union b is equal to n of a plus n of b minus n of a intersection b. Whenever we have n of a union b, n of a intersection b, n of a, n of b, we always use the identity which have all these values. The identity is n of a union b is equal to n of a plus n of b minus n of a intersection b. Now we have the values of n of a union b. So let's put it. We have the value of n of a. Let's put it. We don't have n of b, so we will write it as it is. In the place of n of a union b, it is actually intersection. N of a intersection b, we will write 7. It is not union. Just hold on for a second. It is n of a intersection b. So in the place of n of a union b, you will put 29. In the place of n of a 15, n of b will be as it is, and n of a intersection b is 7. So we substituted the values. 15 minus 7 is 8. 29 is equal to 8 plus n of a union b. Now guys, we need the answer for n of a union b. So 8 will be shifted to the other side. So we get the value n of a union b is 21. So guys, for the solving part, you will get 1 mark, and for the final answer, you will get 1 mark. So total 2 marks. There are 4 questions, but you have to attempt 3. So if you have attempted all 4, 2 marks will be given as extra. It won't be considered in total. And if you have got all 3 correct, then you will get a score of 6 marks. Now, when you're correcting this sum, if you have written the identity properly, you will get half marks. For first 2 steps, you will get half marks. You have got 1 mark. Then for the next step and the last step, you will get, for the first step, you're getting 1 mark. For the first, second, third, and fourth step, you will get half marks. And for the last step, you will get half marks. So total 2 marks. I repeat, identity 1 mark. For the solving part, entire solving part, you will get half marks. And for the final answer, you will get half marks. Now let's proceed further. Question number 3. Attempt any two of the following. Attempt any two of the following for 6 marks. When I am saying attempt any two of the following for 6 marks, you have to solve 2 questions. Total will be 6 marks. That is 3 marks. Each for each question. The first one is, write the following rational number in P upon Q form, that is 0.37. This sum is for 3 marks. The 0.37 recurring, you have to write it in P upon Q form, that is in decimal form. The question has been given and you have to represent it in fraction format. So whatever is the question, you will denote it as x. Let x is equal to 0.37 recurring. And you will mark it as equation number 1. Now if you observe over here, after decimal point, you have 2 digits. And if you have 2 digits, you will multiply throughout by 100. In the left hand side as well as in the right hand side. So multiplying both the sides by 100, it will be 100x is equal to 0.37 bar into 100. So this point will be shifted after 2 digits because we are multiplying by 100. So it will be 37.37 bar. mark it as equation number 2. Then you will subtract equation 1 from 2, that is LHS will get subtracted, RHS will get subtracted. So 100x minus x is equal to 37.37 bar minus 0.37 bar. So 100x minus x is 99x and 37.37 bar, 0.37 bar will give you 37. And x is equal to 99 over here is in multiplication. If I change the side, it will be division. Now, guys, it is of 3 marks. How are you going to give the marking? Now, for first two equations, you will get 1 mark. For first two equations, you will get 1 mark. And for subtracting till the final answer, you will get 2 marks. So first two equations will get 1 mark. From subtracting till the final answer, you will get 2 marks. So first two equation 1 mark. From subtracting till the final answer, if everything is correct, then 2 marks. If the final answer is wrong, half marks will be subtracted. Take the set of natural numbers from 1 to 20 as universal set and show x using Venn diagram. Universal set is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 because you have to consider natural numbers from 1 to 20. Now let's read what is set x. X is a set of all x such that x is an element of natural number. X is greater than 7 but less than 15. X is a value which is greater than 7, less than 15. So elements will be 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And you have to represent it with the help of a Venn diagram. In the model answer, if you see this part, the X part where my cursor is right now, let's ignore this 1. In the Venn diagram, first of all, we will draw a circle with x, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Then we will make a rectangle outside it with the remaining elements and you will mark it as universal set. So this is how you will represent the Venn diagram. So guys, the marking for the Venn diagram is 3. If you have got it properly, right. Now the third one, simplify 5 root 3 plus 2 root 27 plus 1 upon root 3. I had told you whenever you have simplification, your first step is you will factorize the given thirds in the simplest form. Let's consider 5 root 3. Root 3 is already in the simplest form, so let's not factorize. The next one is 2 root 27. Yes, we can definitely factorize root 27. It is 3 into 3 into 3 plus 1 upon root 3. Now 5 root 3 plus this 3, 3, 3 is common. So 1, 3 will come outside. So 2, 3s are 6 root 3 plus 1 upon root 3. Guys, 1 upon root 3. Root 1 upon root 3 is the denominator. You are having an irrational number. So let's rationalize it. We have already studied. So you will multiply the numerator and denominator by root 3 upon root 3. So 5 root 3 plus 6 root 3. They are like thirds. You can see it. So 5 plus 6 will give you 11. Root 3 plus 1 into root 3 will give you root 3. Root 3 into root 3 will give you 3. I repeat, look at the cursor. 1 into root 3 will give you root 3. Root 3 into root 3 will give you 3. Now again we are having root 3 similar, but it is in the form of a fraction. So to solve it in a better way, let's consider a bracket. You will keep 11 as it is. If root 3, I'll consider it as common. So 11 will come as it is. Root 3 goes in common. So nothing is remaining in the numerator. So it will be 1. And in the denominator, it will be 3. If you observe the bracket, you have to add it by cross multiplication. So you will get 33 plus 1 upon 3 root 3. That is 34 upon 3 root 3. Now guys, let's see the marking. It is of 3 marks. So first two steps, like this was the factorization step. So first two step, 1 mark. Second two steps, 2 mark. And the last two step, 1 mark. I mean, first two steps, 1 mark. Next two steps, 1 mark. Last two steps, 1 mark. So 3 marks for 6 steps. Attempt any of the following. Your fourth question, which is of 4 marks. You have to just attempt one question and you will get 4 marks. The question is, 70 trees were planted by Parth and 90 trees were planted by Pradnya on the occasion of tree plantation week. Out of these, 25 trees were planted by both of them together. How many trees were planted by Parth or Pradnya? So guys, it is a word problem. Let's do it. Let's consider the set of trees planted by Parth as A. Let A be the trees planted by Parth, so N of A will be 70. Let B be the trees planted by Pradnya, so N of B will be 90. It is already given. 25 trees were planted by both of them. When I'm using the word both, both of them planted 25 trees. Both means intersection. So it is N of A intersection B, which is 25. How many trees were planted by Parth or Pradnya? When I'm saying or, Parth or Pradnya, it means union. So you have to find out A union B. We are having N of A, N of B, N of A intersection B, and you have to find A union B. And yes, you're perfectly right. You have this identity which has to be used. N of A union B is N of A plus N of B minus N of A intersection B. N of A is 70, N of B is 90, and N of A intersection B is 25. N of A intersection B is 25. It is not union, it is intersection. So let's replace it by intersection. Just give me a second. It is N of A intersection B. Now guys, let's substitute the value. We have N of A, N of B, and N of A intersection B. 70 plus 90 minus 25 gives you 135. The trees planted by Parth or Pradnya is 135. So let's check how to give the markings. It is of 4 marks. So for N of A and N of B, for N of A and N of B, if you have write it properly, for N of A, you will get half marks. N of B, you will get half marks. For N of A intersection B, you will get half marks. And for writing trees planted by Parth or Pradnya as N of A union B, you will get half marks. And for the solving part, you will get 2 marks. I repeat, N of A half, N of B half, N of A intersection B half. Trees planted by Parth or Pradnya is N of A union B will give you half marks. And for the solving part, you will get 2 marks. Represent the number root 5 on the number line along with Pythagoras theorem working. Let's check the Pythagoras theorem working. We know if we want to represent root 5, root 5 will become the hypotenuse. You can consider scale as 2 cm is 1 unit or 3 cm is 1 unit. Anything will do. Let's check what will be the base with the help of Pythagoras theorem. We all know the Pythagoras theorem. Hypotenuse side square is equal to base square plus height square. Hypotenuse will be replaced by root 5 square. Base we will find height is 1. Root 5 square is 5. Base is base and 1 square will be 1. So base square will be 5 minus 1, that is 4. So base will be root of 4, that is 2. So base will be 2. So we will consider the base as 2. This is the hypotenuse. You will draw an arc and you will get root 5. This is for 4 marks. So guys, 3 marks for the drawing and 1 mark for Pythagoras theorem. 3 marks for the drawing and 1 mark for the Pythagoras theorem. But without Pythagoras theorem, if you have solved it, then you won't get it right because it is compulsory that you have to draw it with Pythagoras theorem because it was mentioned in the question. It was mentioned in the question, so it is compulsory. So if you have not written Pythagoras theorem, you won't get marks. And if you have done everything correctly, so 3 marks for the diagram and 1 mark for the Pythagoras theorem. I hope you have answered everything correctly and everyone has scored full marks. So thank you so much and all the best.